We're doing the same as earlier, right? Everything the same?
Everything's the same.
And that's up
well,
now?
We're not going to end it the same. How do we end it last time? Oh, it was the other one.
Is that how you talk about your sound?
Yeah.
It's got these vibrations.
It's got these cracks. No, there's like a brace.
It
is loose.
Let me see. Where is it?
I don't know which one. I don't know which notes it plays on. I'm darn sure. And I just took it to someone to have it cleaned and kind of fixed up.
They didn't find it?
I guess
or they didn't?
I don't know. It wasn't making it. Maybe something he did. Because he said he cleaned up a bunch of welds. I trust him.
With an issue you didn't have before. Littlestown. Just south of Gettysburg. Almost in there.
Well, I guess he meets me halfway.
Oh.
At the rest of the Delaware House on 95.
Gotcha.
So it turns into 2 hour trip.
Less.
Or he lives in Glen Burn. He's a professor at
Gettysburg. That was really easy earlier.
It's maybe if we played it at a faster tempo, they would walk faster.
It's the distance. It takes forever for them to get to the chairs. But once they get to the chairs, it's very quick.
Yeah, exactly.
They start all the way back down.
Mm-hmm. I did one. Was I with you, Justin, when we did something at the...
I did one at Rutgers Nursing School.
What was it?
We can encourage him. Let me get some water before we play. That'll work.
First beat's empty. One, two. I have a drive in committee a lot either.
No, she told me she's gonna sit out in the neighborhood at some place. She's gonna be a blogger too.
She wanted me to.
Yeah, I just don't wanna get all the money stuck out here.
Oh, no.
And not.
Well, you're not supposed to.
There's always the subway, so.
That is true. Oh, yeah, yeah, that is true.
We're not doing that.
Yeah. I tried to improve it, so.
We give them water or something, they can't see the left street. No, they're searching.
They're still searching?
Yeah, Kline's the meeting person. So, she's the meeting person. Yeah, she's had a hard time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like
a tough crowd here. It's a tough level. Yeah.
So,
well, George Washington wrote them.
It's funny to say that he's retiring.
Yeah, they're all just like before you can take it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good afternoon. My name is Dan Filler, and I am the Dean of the Kline School of Law. The national anthem will be sung by Bridget Fasano, a member of our graduating class.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of
Please be seated. Thank you, Bridget. That That was outstanding. It is my pleasure to introduce the president of Drexel University, John Fry.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the commencement exercises for Drexel's Thomas R. Kline School of Law, and especially to the great and incredibly resilient class of 2021. Let's give them a round. You have made it to this day through one of the most trying times ever for our university and for all of our collective communities. But I hope the challenges of the last year have made this occasion even more special. This is a wonderful day to celebrate your hard work and to think about the journey ahead. Congratulations to all of you, and congratulations to your family and your friends who supported your studies along the way. 15 years ago, Drexel launched the nation's first new law school by a major research university in a quarter century. It was an audacious undertaking and one that required a great deal of commitment and courage. But we aimed high. We set out to create a program with excellent faculty, a rigorous curriculum, and a set of rich experiential training opportunities. In many ways, we have well exceeded our expectations, even as we continue to learn and to grow. Others have certainly taken notice. U.S. News recently ranked Kline Law among the top 40 private law schools in the country. And since many of you have started at the law school in 2018, the school rose 20 places during your time at the law school. Our Master of Legal Studies graduates are heavily in demand in the growing compliance arena. For our law school graduates, a key strength of Kline Law is that you don't just study the law, you also get to apply it. And you have the added benefit of practicing your craft at the Kline Institute of Trial Advocacy. This is the only facility of its kind in the United States, allowing students to hone skills in the grandeur of an historic setting with contemporary courtroom technology. The Institute's stunning building came to Drexel as part of Tom Kline's extraordinary naming gift. And Tom is here today. Let's give him a round of applause. It's an inspiring place to practice the law, and its downtown location puts Kline Law in the heart of Philadelphia's storied legal community. Guided by our stellar faculty and supported by such outstanding facilities, Kline Law students are making a real impact. This class has excelled in so many ways. Kline Law teams won the regional championship of the national trial competition. Two Kline Law moot court teams met in the finals of the national moot court competition. Kline Law students in the Andy and Gwen Stern Community Lawyering Clinic helped amplify the voices of West Philadelphia community members while holding law enforcement accountable for its actions during last summer's Black Lives Matter protests, and so much more. Our students have also made an impact in co-op employment at law firms, general counsel offices, government agencies, judicial organizations, and public interest organizations. Many of you have joined others in contributing thousands of hours of pro bono service. You've represented marginalized populations that often have trouble finding advocates, immigrants, the elderly, the disabled, artists, those living with HIV/AIDS. It has been said, wisely, that the success of our society and our democracy rests upon our willingness to think of each other and not only ourselves. To my mind, that perfectly describes the role of an advocate. And as advocates, and legal scholars trained at Drexel, I know that you embrace this principle, that you will step up in your communities, that you will take on the solemn responsibility of leadership. You are entering a challenging world, but it is a world that desperately, desperately needs you. It's a world that cries out for justice, racial justice, economic justice, environmental justice. It needs the many contributions you will make as practitioners and as citizens of your communities. Your role as advocates and legal experts will be pivotal. Keeping that in mind, I look forward to hearing from our keynote speaker, U.S. District Court Judge C. Darnell Jones. Judge Jones has been an inspiration to his fellow jurists since his first election to the Philadelphia Court as a reform candidate running solely on his qualifications and his independence. His 21-year tenure on the city bench included a stint as the president judge, elected by his peers as the greatest sign of their respect. On the federal court, he has been tapped for leadership positions time and time again. Judge Jones is also a wise and gifted teacher who has given back by training new generations of lawyers. You can have no better role model in the legal community than Judge Jones. Let's give him a warm Drexel welcome. Once again, thanks to everyone here today for honoring these graduates, and congratulations to the Kline Law class of 2021. And now, I'm honored to welcome the Vice Chair of Drexel University's Board of Trustees, Stan Silverman.
Thank you, President Fry. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Graduates, alumni, family and friends, and members of the Thomas R. Kline School of Law and the university community, on behalf of the Drexel Board of Trustees, welcome to today's commencement ceremony for the graduating class of 2021. Graduates, you are dedicating your lives to the practice of law at a time that could not be more important to protecting our democracy, our rule of law, values, and rights enshrined in our Constitution. We are counting you to protect them. You are starting your careers after more than a year of disruptive change brought on by the COVID-19 pandemic. Out of disruption, however, comes opportunity. We are not bouncing back, but springing forward with improved ways of doing things. As you pursue your career, the best advice I can share with you is to step out of your comfort zone. Be open to new opportunities that come your way and create your own opportunities. You never know where these might take you. Embrace change. It's the only constant in life. The story of Icarus, a character in Greek mythology, is a great metaphor for how one should pilot their career. According to legend, Icarus flew too high and too close to the sun. The wax holding the wings to his back melted, and he crashed into the sea. So the question is, should Icarus have played it safe and flown lower, avoiding the risk posed by the sun? During your career, should you play it safe, avoiding getting out of your comfort zone by flying too low? Seth Godin, the author of The Icarus Deception, writes, and I quote, "It is far more dangerous to fly too low than too high, even though it might feel safer to fly low. By flying low, you settle for low expectations and small dreams and guarantee yourself less than what you are capable of achieving. By flying too low, you also shortchange not only yourself, but those who depend on you or might benefit from your work." End of quote. During your career, be sure you don't fly too low. Get out of your comfort zone and fly high. And if you crash, you'll pick yourself up and fly again. The following personal attributes will help you advance in your career. Your commitment to yourself and others to always strive for excellence. How you differentiate yourself by doing new things, and how you proactively implement positive change in everything that you do. Your interpersonal skills and how you treat and lead others, your common sense and good critical judgment, and most importantly, your moral compass. A good friend of mine, Robert A. McDonald, former United States Secretary of Veterans Affairs, and the former chairman and CEO of the Procter & Gamble Company, once shared with me a passage from the West Point that reads, and I quote, "Make us choose the harder right than the easier wrong," end of quote. Let me repeat that. Make us choose the harder right than the easier wrong. Remember this, especially when you run into situations that require ethical choices, difficult ethical choices, and you will definitely run into these situations. Your credibility, honesty, ethics, and integrity determine your reputation. It's your most cherished personal and prized possession. Once lost, your reputation is very difficult, if not impossible, to earn back. So on behalf of the Drexel Board of Trustees, congratulations and our very best wishes to you. I also want to extend my congratulations to our graduates' families. Your love, support, and sacrifice were very important in helping our graduates succeed and bringing them to this very special day. Congratulations, fellow Dragons.
It is my honor and privilege to introduce the chair of our law school board, Thomas R. Kline. Our law school board deserves special recognition for their extraordinary support of our law school. Mr. Kline.
Good afternoon. Congratulations, 2021 graduates. You and I will both hang on your walls in your law offices together. I'm proud to be part of your education, proud to be part of your life. As I look out on this wonderful group, I can't think anything other than pride and joy in a time that has been lacking of joy. There could be no more joyous word to say today than congratulations. As we turn the corner from a pandemic which has turned our lives, all of us, upside down and inside out, this today is truly a new start. We are on the verge of something new. Commencement means beginning. Congratulations for thriving and surviving the upheaval. The pandemic exposed vast inequality in our country and around the world. We learned many things this past year about ourselves, about our country, and about our world. But one thing to me stands out: the need for lawyers to uphold the rule of law to ensure justice for the most vulnerable has never been greater. Neither has the need for lawyers been more evident in securing our democracy. At every turn, an independent judiciary coupled with dedicated lawyers is exactly what has withstood the test in the most challenging of times. And that's where you come in. That's your entry point. Enter class of 2021, Kline School of Law of Drexel University. We need more dedicated lawyers, not fewer. We need more dedicated lawyers in America, the exact kind we have trained at the Kline School of Law, to do whatever is necessary, whatever the challenge, whenever called upon to meet that challenge. I've proudly watched our law school grow in stature and, yes, rise in the rankings. That is because of you. And it's also a testament to our extraordinary faculty and administration. I would like to say a brief word about our commencement speaker and recipient of an honorary degree from Drexel University, Kline School of Law. Judge Darnell Jones has been a stalwart supporter and advisor to our law school, having served many years on our board of advisors. Look up his Wikipedia page as something you do before you go to bed tonight. His career will serve as a model for you. Having arrived in Philadelphia to become a public defender in 1975, going on to become a judge of our Philadelphia Common Pleas Court for 20 years, and then on to an illustrious career as a federal judge. I'm so pleased that he's here. I've admired his career, and I'm proud, Judge Jones, to call you my friend. Congratulations to you, class of 2021, on navigating the perils and the stress. Life will return to normal. We will be on Zoom, but less. We will be back in courtrooms. We will be back in conference rooms. We will be back at happy hours on Friday afternoons in our respective law offices after you pass the online bar exam. At home, like, think about it. You get to take the bar exam at home. Good luck as you pursue your journey, and as I like to say, make your unmasked mark on the world. And as I also like to say, there will never be a shortage of causes worth pursuing, and never an oversupply of great lawyers to undertake those causes. I wish for you, like me, that someday you will stand on a podium like this and 43 years later say that you have enjoyed every minute of being a lawyer and that you believe in your heart that you have made a difference. Welcome, fellow colleagues and lawyers, very shortly. I'm very proud.
Thank you, Tom. And good afternoon, class of 2021. It is hot, but we are here, and what a gift it is to be able to spend this afternoon with all of you. Honestly, when we started planning this event about a year ago, we did it wondering if it would even be possible to share this signature celebration of all of your hard work and all of your accomplishments and all the possibilities that lay ahead. But here on this day, this bright, hot, sunny day in Philadelphia, we come together at a commencement that is at once both mundane and utterly abnormal. Mundane because it's May 19th, and what else would we be doing but sitting at a commencement? But abnormal for a million different reasons, not the least of which is that instead of gathering in our most common spot, the Kimmel Center, we come together at a friend's house at LaSalle University, which has generously shared McCarthy Stadium. This is 2021, you know the deal? We do what we have to do, and we feel grateful when things break right. And on this day, at least, I think things are definitely breaking right, especially if you brought a bottle of water somewhere. I could not be prouder to celebrate with all of you. And I hope you will stop for a moment, all of you graduates, to breathe in the enormity of this afternoon, be present to the fact that we're finally all here together in person, in community today. As I walked up, I thought, when was the last time I did anything like this? But even more, I ask you to pay attention to some of the little details that mark commencement as a genuine milestone event, a rare and wonderful acknowledgement of grand achievement. Notice the strange feeling of the regalia. It's an exceptional moment, the anticipation of lining up and coming up on stage, and the rush you'll feel afterward being fawned over by the people you love and laying eyes on friends and faculty and colleagues you haven't seen in forever. Of course, this moment, this achievement, didn't just drop out of the sky. We never arrive alone, and our paths are always inextricably tied to others. Gwendolyn Brooks wrote, "We are each other's harvest. We are each other's business. We are each other's magnitude and bond." Long before you arrived to your first law school class, all of you, every one of you, had people helping you along the way, making sure you didn't slip and fall, ensuring you would finish the race and be with us here today in these seats. Now, maybe it was your mom or dad, your grandma or grandpa who took care of you, stayed up late waiting for you to get home, irritating as that might have been, cheering from the sidelines at your successes and offering you a big hug when things did not go right. And McCarthy Stadium today is teeming with parents and grandparents, spouses and partners, siblings, cousins, aunts, uncles, godparents. There are those friends here today whose shoulders are wet from your tears, the people who hung around even when you had to cancel dinner yet again because you had too much homework to do. You underestimated con law yet again. We've been missing our loved ones this past year. And for some of you, I hope today is a grand reunion. And yet there are others who couldn't make it here today. For some of you, home is hundreds or thousands of miles away from Philadelphia. Your supporters couldn't be here, but they remain close in mind, and we're so aware that they're here for you. And some of them are streaming. And of course, some of the most important people in your lives are no longer with us in body, but they live on in every beat of our hearts. There are so many people. There are the people who greeted you when you arrived at the Kline School of Law, all around me, behind me, in front of me, on the sides. I can tell you that the faculty and staff of the law school pour their hearts into your success. It's so much more than just teaching you in class, although we like to think that's pretty important. Many of you probably don't realize how much we worry about you, almost, not quite, but almost as much as your parents do when something in your life goes awry. Breakups, illnesses, even a lousy grade on your final. We know it happens. We feel those pains with you. And you may not know also how much we cherish the opportunity to help you along, whether it's giving advice, calling employers, and telling them that you're the best thing since sliced bread, or even better. Judge Jones, I'll be calling you. And you know, there are people working behind the scenes every single day to make this moment possible. The leadership of Drexel University, the president, the provost, the board, and others whose commitment to the law school has been the gold standard, ensuring that the Kline School of Law would become the widely admired school it is today. And the admiration only grows. It only grows. There's Tom Kline, who experiences your success as his success, and his commitment to this law school, and more importantly, our students and graduates, you guys, is literally awe-inspiring. Anyone who's struck up a conversation with him knows Tom just wants to chat with you and meet you and get to know you. And collectively, all of us are filled with pride and admiration. But here's the amazing news. For all that's come before, this is only the beginning. As Tom said, this is, after all, a commencement. Think about that word, to start, to initiate, to begin. Today you commence. because what's ahead is that you're going to be partners at great law firms. You're going to be compliance directors and public interest lawyers. You're going to be entrepreneurs. You're going to be in the C-suite. Some of you are going to run for office and lead our states and nation through this big century that lies ahead. I think all of you know, we've been through these days, that we live in a moment when some basic assumptions are not a given anymore. Will we truly be a democracy? Will there be liberty and justice for all? Will our nation meet the expectations we set for ourselves in our Constitution and laws? And as a guy who's getting older and grayer, I can say this: we need you, all of you, to lead us to the promised land. We have never needed your talents, your vision, or your heart more than we do today. Here I have to bracket something, because sometimes in a commencement, you have to take care of a little bit of business. And I need to stop for a second now to speak directly to the friends and family, all of you guys off to the side and in back, particularly of our JD graduates. And not everyone here is a JD graduate, but some of you are, and you're preparing for the bar this summer. Now, if there's one piece of wisdom coming out of the pandemic, it's surely the recognition of how much we need each other. We are so eager to get together and connect. Unfortunately, for our JD graduates, the law school experience isn't quite over yet. Quite the opposite. Preparing for the bar exam this summer, your loved ones will be required to study as they have never studied before. Every professor here, all of those brilliant ones, every brilliant and successful lawyer that I know had to check out of their normal life for 2 to 3 months to study for the single toughest exam most of us have ever taken. Now, every one of our graduates can pass that exam because we accept no students who cannot pass the exam. That's the good news, but here's the bad news. They're gonna have to study, so please don't be hurt. Please don't be insulted. If after all this time apart, this painful year plus, your graduate has to say no to a Sunday dinner or a gathering at the pool, because during the next few months, the support these JDs need most from you will be your grace, when they simply have to say no to your invitations. So everyone, get your calendars out. Mark July 28th on your calendar. The bar will be over and they will be free. Have them over for dinner. Make it a plan today. But enough of the practical details. Let's celebrate the achievements of our graduates. They struggled through classes that turned out to be so much more difficult than they expected. They did the work. Whether they were drafting compliance policies, advising clients, standing up in court and winning cases in front of federal judges, cases that lawyers admitted to the bar would struggle and probably unsuccessfully litigate. You guys have participated in law review and competitions, the SBA, affinity groups, student associations. You've grown as individuals, even as you lifted up the community. You've had jobs and families and responsibilities. You've set aside many other priorities over these years to make room for this precious experience. Never underestimate what you have achieved. So it's no wonder I feel such pride today. I look out at a group of graduates that has earned every bit of this recognition through good times and bad times, and there were plenty of bad times. You climbed the mountain, and you brought each other with you, cribbing the words of the great 19th and 20th century civil rights leader, Mary Church Terrell. You were lifting while you climbed. It's been a tough year, a brutal year, but you've made it. It's time to commence the next stage of your life. Congratulations to all of you, the members of the class of 2021. Today, graduates are not leaving the law school community. All of you are simply joining our 1,683 previous graduates as members of the alumni community. Rebecca Trella, chair of the Kline School of Law Alumni Council, is here to welcome all of you and share some words of wisdom with the class of 2021.
Good afternoon, class of 2021. I'm Rebecca Trella, class of 2012. On behalf of the Drexel Alumni Council, I'd like to extend my congratulations and all of ours on completing your education at the end of such a difficult year, and to welcome you to the next chapter, legal practice. This is that moment in time that Churchill calls the end of the beginning, the first victory of what will become many victories. When I was in your shoes 9 years ago, someone told me that practicing law isn't anything like law school. And in part, that was right. Very good news. I'm happy to report that I have not used the rule against perpetuities one time in the last 9 years. On the other hand, a little bit of practicing advice. This isn't covered in civil procedure, but I suggest that you get on friendly terms with every court clerk, prothonotary, prison coordinator, mail person, executive assistant, and filing clerk that you possibly can. A staggering and unforeseen portion of your job as a young professional will be devoted to and contingent on these information gatekeepers. Your class, 2021, has a tremendous advantage. In 2020, in the early part of 2021, law school was an exercise in adapting to and responding to change. That's exactly the foundation that you need to thrive in a legal practice environment. Some of you have powered through take-home finals with small children in the same room. Some of you have endured four-hour Zoom job interviews. Some of you have established your first connections with clients and professional networks solely online. The resilience, bravery, and grit that you have shown over the past year make this class representative of everything that the law school spirit has to offer, and I am delighted and proud to welcome you all to the alumni community. The Drexel Kline School of Law began as just a vision over 15 years ago, and with each graduating class, that ideal becomes more tangible because of each of you. Each of you has an important role in that future. As Dean Filler just said, you are one in an alumni body of just over 1,600. Compared to our fellow top 100 law schools, those have an alumni body of 20 to 30 times our size. And so some might see our small size as a negative, but I know it's our strength. Because there are fewer alums, how each of us act outwardly and how we support one another matters more than it does at other schools. So I urge you, don't hesitate. Send that email. Pick up the phone. Lawyers are standing by. We would all like to meet you, get to know you, and connect with you. These are your people. And as the years pass in your practice, you will again be called upon to marshal your resilience, your bravery, and your grit to meet new challenges. Your jobs will change. Your families will grow. Many of you will move. I implore you to all stay involved. Stay in touch with your networks. Support the success of your classmates, even if their practice has nothing whatsoever to do with your practice. They are not your competition. They are proof of what is possible and a credit to the entire group. Each one of you will be getting an email this fall about how to join the alumni network, get involved in our events, and meet more folks. Please look out for that and look out for one another. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thanks, Rebecca. Continuing a tradition our inaugural class of 2009 created, our Student Bar Association wants to recognize some very special people. Abhinandan Pandey, Richard Crane, Sandra Grace are with us on stage today to present the SBA Awards.
Good afternoon, everyone. The Diavin Champion of Diversity Award. This award is presented to an individual who demonstrates diversity, inclusion, and cultural competency in the law school and the legal community by promoting equal opportunity in race, religion, culture, sexual identification, and expression. I would like Richard Crane to present this award to Professor Wendy Green. Unfortunately, Professor Green was unable to attend the graduation. Her award is accepted by Daniel Dean Filler. The Diven Student Champion of Diversity Award. This award is presented to a graduating student who most exemplifies diversity, inclusion, and cultural competency in the law school and the legal community. I would like Richard Crane to present this award to Angeles Torres McBride.
Hello, class of 2021. What a day to remember. I'm just gonna take a quick selfie. This was not sanctioned, but I'm sorry, Dean McGovern. Everybody smile. All right, we'll take one later. Congratulations, class of 2021. But most importantly, congrats to all your family, friends, and loved ones who endured and supported you for the past 2 to 3 years. They're the real MVPs out here. And now the reason that they actually allowed me to come up here, it is my honor to introduce the Dean Jennifer L. Rosato Excellence in the Classroom Award. This award is presented to a faculty member who taught a first-year course to the members of the graduating class and demonstrates excellence in teaching, strong relationships with students inside and outside of the classroom, and reputation for intellectual integrity. This award is presented to Professor Amy Kahn. Next up is the Carl Toby Oxholm, the third outstanding contribution to the Thomas R. Kline School of Law Community Award. This award is presented to a member of our law school community who has exhibited and continued a commitment to the betterment of the Thomas R. Kline School of Law. The recipient may be a faculty member, staff member, co-op sponsor, pro bono supervisor, or any other member of the community. It is my honor and very distinct pleasure to present this award to my mentor, Professor Veronica Finkelstein.
Some people up here are very happy. In the spirit of creating new traditions, the Student Bar Association has also established two new awards. I would like to invite Roger J. Dennis, Emeritus Dean of the Kline School of Law, and Mary McGovern, former Assistant Dean of Administration, to the podium to present our new awards, the Roger J. Dennis Distinction in Teaching Award and the Mary K. McGovern Exceptional Contribution to the Student Experience Award.
The award given in my name is presented to a faculty member who taught an upper-level course to members of the graduating class and demonstrated excellence in teaching, showed creativity in the classroom, interest in students, and the ability to teach complex and difficult information. It's my great pleasure to give the award to Professor David Cohn while he still has some space in his office for teaching awards.
Good afternoon. The Mary Kay McGovern Exceptional Contribution to the Student Experience Award is presented to a staff member at the law school who demonstrates a consistent and unwavering commitment to ensuring that students have a fulfilling and rewarding experience at the Thomas R. Kline School of Law. I am proud to present this award to Danielle Bordley.
At this time, I am pleased to once again invite President Fry to the lectern.
It is the distinct privilege of the university to confer an honorary degree upon an individual who merits recognition as a symbol of our high esteem. I'll ask our provost, Dr. Paul Jensen, to present the candidate for the honorary degree. He will be assisted in the hooding of our candidate by Dean Filler. Provost Jensen.
President Fry, in recognition of his outstanding achievements and service to the legal profession, it is my distinct privilege to present you Judge C. Darnell Jones.
Senior U.S. District Court Judge C. Darnell Jones II has been a role model for fellow jurists since his election to the bench in Philadelphia on a slate of reform candidates recommended for their independence and their qualifications. He received the Pennsylvania Bar Association's highest rating during a subsequent election bid and has taught extensively at a number of leading universities. He also served as the president judge of the Philadelphia Court of Common Pleas, Pennsylvania's largest and busiest court system. Since 2008, Judge Jones has served on the federal court based in Philadelphia following his nomination by President George W. Bush. On several occasions, Judge Jones served by designation on the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Third Circuit. He also served a six-year term on the Committee on Criminal Law of the Judicial Conference of the United States, having been appointed by Chief Justice John Roberts in 2012. Among his other judicial responsibilities, Judge Jones presided over federal grand juries. During his 21-year tenure on the Philadelphia Court, Judge Jones presided over numerous civil and criminal trials and served in many capacities, including 3 years as president judge from 2005 to 2008. Before joining the bench, Judge Jones served as a trial attorney at the Defender Association of Philadelphia and subsequently became chief of the Family Court Division for that organization. His undergraduate degree is from Southwestern College and received his law degree from the American University Washington College of Law. He has taught at the St. Joseph University's Graduate College and the National Judicial College and serves as an adjunct professor of law at the University of Pennsylvania Law School and as an adjunct professor of law at Temple University's Beasley School of Law. He is a member of the University of Pennsylvania American Inn of Court and the Thomas R. Kline Law School American Inn at Court, where he is also a member of our Law School Advisory Board. For his many contributions to an independent judiciary, his service to the profession, and his legal acumen, Drexel University is proud to present C. Darnell Jones II with the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Drexel University, under the charter issued by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I confer upon you, Judge C. Darnell Jones, the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations, Judge Jones. And Judge Jones will now deliver the commencement address.
Good afternoon and congratulations. I know it's hot, I shall be brief, no matter how long it takes. I congratulate each one of you, students. I know your pain, I've been there. But this is a glorious afternoon we all share in your accomplishment. I am deeply humbled and deeply appreciative of the honor that has been bestowed upon me, but I assure each one of you as you graduate, I sat there where you now sit, never dreaming that I would be standing here. And I say that because one of you or more of you will be standing here at some point in time in your future. You'll be seated on courts, in courtrooms, in boardrooms, and I pray on the playground with your family and your offspring and your neighbors. I've been a judge for almost 34 years now, and people ask me, what were your major accomplishments? And whenever I'm asked that question, I always answer, well, there are two that come to mind. One occurred in 2005, the week of Hurricane Katrina. Like so many Americans, I watched the news, and I saw people stranded on a bridge. And day after day after day, they remained on that bridge, and so many of us questioned, how could that be in America? Several of my friends and I decided, let's do something. We secured two trucks, a lot of contributions, and drove to New Orleans, ending up in a small town called Slidell, Louisiana, where we slept outside on the ground for about a week. Before I left, I sent a letter to my colleagues on the Court of Common Pleas telling them that I felt that God put me here to do more than judge and ask for their prayers and blessings and their support. They came through like you could never imagine. I think that was one of the most successful trips I've ever taken in my lifetime. I will never forget it. And more importantly, the people who we helped have assured us that they will never forget it. And I bring that to your attention today because at the heart of it, it's all about public service. The second one. There is a portrait on the wall in my courtroom at the federal courthouse. And for years, quite frankly, I had no idea who the person was. One day during a recess, one of my law clerks strolled to the back of the courtroom and looked closer at the portrait, came back and Googled the name. The name was Justice Robert Greer. Originally from Pennsylvania, he was a justice of the United States Supreme Court. Two of his most famous accomplishments were the prize case, which declared President Lincoln's blockade of southern ports constitutional, and thus, some say, delivered a dagger to the Confederacy during the Civil War. The second one, Dred Scott. Justice Greer concurred in full with the majority opinion delivered by Chief Justice Roger Taney in invalidating the Missouri Compromise, and in that opinion stated that the Supreme Court did not consider Dred Scott to be an American citizen. He was, in fact, an inherited and owned slave. Thereby, he was restricted from bringing any kind of suit in the federal court. Now, there are a lot of my colleagues and people in the community who have urged me to have that portrait removed from my courtroom. I've shared two thoughts with them. One, I sit in the United States courthouse, not in the C. Darnell Jones courthouse. And the second one, I much prefer that it remain on the wall of my courtroom so that I can tell this story to lawyers, to judges, to jurors, for it is a larger and more meaningful example of the spirit of what we have all come to call that living document, the United States Constitution. So one of these days when my portrait is hung on that wall, I trust that mine will face his and bear the inscription, "The Honorable C. Darnell Jones II, how you like us now?" Students, family, supporters, all of you who have assembled, I urge you, I urge you, be the change that you want to see in the world. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Judge Jones, for those inspiring remarks. It is a tradition of legal education, one that we have embraced, that the last speaker be a graduating student. Our students have selected Angelise Torres McBride through a competition judged by the students themselves. With that buildup, I present you Angelise Torres McBride.
Just before moving from Chicago to Philadelphia, a friend of my parents gifted me a canvas to decorate my new home. At the time, I thought, okay, that's an interesting gift for a soon-to-be law student. I thought we just needed a surplus of pens and legal pads, the colorful ones, of course, to coordinate for each class. But I mean, what else do law students really need otherwise? The answer? A lot of random things. Never in my life did I think I would check off ring light from my school supply list. Yet, here we are in 2021 doing moot court competitions over Zoom with stellar lighting. Though it's been right in front of me for the last 3 years, I only recently came to realize that the gift was not just about having something to fill my new space, but about the message. It hangs on the wall in front of my bed, a place where I can read it daily. It's the first thing I see when I wake up in the morning, and the last thing I see when I close my eyes at night. Unless, of course, it was one of those sleepless nights going down the research rabbit hole for 1L briefs, or 3L briefs, so my eyes didn't do the whole close and then open again thing. A message I've read so many times that I have it unintentionally committed to memory. Live the life you've always dreamed of. Never in my ancestors' wildest dreams could they have ever imagined I would be here. Yet, despite a history of longing for a better life, this first-generation Puerto Rican woman stands before you, y yo susurro lo logramos. And I whisper, we made it. Be fearless in the face of adversity. That's what being a lawyer is all about. We are zealous advocates for our clients, for public policy, and for justice. Kline School of Law, if nothing else, is the place where we learned this. The place where we were hand-selected to join a community of fierce agents of change. The place where we all of a sudden hated Socrates and his methods. Where work smarter, not harder, meant Post got the fox Pearson put in work for. The place where we stood together as the greatest adversity any of us have ever faced became a terrifying reality. If we can restore spring break, we needn't worry about the rest. Never stop learning. Literally, we've got 10 weeks to refresh what we learned over the last 2 to 3 years. I'll see you on the other side of the bar. Use your imagination whenever possible. Look. I don't think any of us could have successfully analyzed the foreseeability of a 2020 pandemic on a torts exam. Now I'm starting to think Paul's graph wasn't that outlandish of a case. But never before have I met a group of people who so tirelessly imagine a new world, one without hunger or pain or injustice, but filled with equity, love, and truth. Recognize the beauty that surrounds you. Maybe you'll find it in that shared connection over perfect purple highlighters, or in the pages of the blue book. I definitely will not look for it in the murky, brown water of the Schuylkill River. But we can remind ourselves to check in with reality, to practice compassion, to listen to our neighbor, to realize the humanity that lives in all of us. Remember where you came from, but never lose sight of where you are going. To the class of 2021, as we venture on in our individual careers, never forget sing-along dance parties at Howl at the Moon or post-finals group therapy at Landmark. We are a class of doers, a community of risk takers. We challenge the status quo, especially when the city tried to take away our food trucks. From cramped 1L lecture halls with constantly broken chairs to 6 feet apart, we did this law school thing together. Be you. A phrase not written on my favorite going to law school gift, but embedded within. We have given as much of ourselves to Kline School of Law as it has given to us. And hopefully, we've left a little mark of our time here, beyond just our adverse possession of specific study tables on campus. Live the life you've always dreamed of. Be fearless in the face of adversity. Never stop learning. Use your imagination whenever possible. Recognize the beauty that surrounds you. Remember where you came from, but never lose sight of where you are going. Be you. With Dragon Pride, we venture on. Thank you.
Thank you, Angeles, for those wise and wonderful and humane words. So now we're at the moment that everyone has been waiting for. Will the candidates for the degree of Master of Legal Studies please rise? Will the candidates for the degree of LLM, the Master of Laws degree, please rise? And will the candidates for the degree of Juris Doctor please rise? Candidates, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Drexel University under the charter issued by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and upon the recommendation of your faculty, I confer upon you the degrees indicated with all the dignities, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. In token thereof, Dean Filler will present each of you with your diploma from the Thomas R. Kline School of Drexel University. Congratulations. Graduates, the marshals will now direct you to the stage to be recognized individually.
Sanad Hoshan.
Congratulations. You may want to take a
picture. Oh. UC Ned. Congratulations. Suzanne LaBerge. Jessica Holt. Stephen M. Gambesha. Shantavia Monet Flowers. Nicholas Cassium. Tosha Finisi. Kate Taylor. Jennifer Brank. Jacqueline Ann Jones. Pavneet Kaur. Nikia Brown. Irvashi Thwani. Magavi Kanani Savalia. Yangsung Choi. Michelle D. Dixon. Brittany Ann Schrader. Elena M. Foster Allen. Dejanae L. Davis, the Philadelphia Trial Lawyers Association James J. Mandarino Award for Trial Advocacy. Chantez R. DeGraffenried. Michael Amugo. Christian Prisco. Veronica M. DiBello. Nabula Alam. Alina Sangha Robeson Park. Okay. Jalila Abdullahi, the Clinical Legal Education Association Outstanding Externship Student Award. Tavia T. Jenkins. Angeles Torres McBride, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Leadership in the Law School Community, the Diven Champion of Diversity Award. Bridget Ann Fasano. Abhinandan Pandey. Richard J. Crane. Sandra A. Grace. Richard M. Dunn, Jr. Chloe Renee DeOna. Kelly L. Brazinger. Kimberly Quinn. Nicole Suzanne Ferlani, cum laude. Ryan Michael Nacino, the Kline School of Law Trial Team Award for Outstanding Advocacy. Reese M. McGovern, cum laude. Whitney Amber Petrie, summa cum laude, the Dean's Award for Outstanding Performance as a Law Student, the National Association of Women Lawyers Outstanding Law Student Award, Outstanding Achievement in the Health Law Concentration. Crystal Rose Bordoni Cowley, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Achievement in Legal Ethics. Kathleen M. Principale, summa cum laude, the Dean's Award for Exceptional Achievement in Law School, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Leadership in the Law School Community. Kaylee J. Gordon, cum laude. Michael J. Bonner. Anna R. Ryan, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Pro Bono Student. Thomas Andrew Maximyuk, the Faculty Award for Academic Success as a Law Student. Frederick Naeem Poindexter. Madalena Sophia Rizzo, cum laude. Nicholas X. Brock. Deirdre Ryan Mulligan. Brenna Wasserman, Outstanding Achievement in the Intellectual Property Law Concentration. Sarah Powell Lee, cum laude. Lexi Lynn Tarnowski. Brittany Cruz. Justine M. Fuga, magna cum laude. Kayla M. Panic, cum laude. Megan K. Heinz. Michael J. DeYoung.
Congratulations.
Madeline Kelly Correnti. Paige L. Baldwin.
Congratulations.
Jillian M. Kennedy. Tyler Marcus Leaders. Kira Chesley Sedbury.
Hey, how are you?
Shebnem Domiolu. Sarah Marie Thacker. Nicole Teresa Pine. Alexis M. Walker. Lindsay K. McElhattan, cum laude. Alyssa C. Mulgrave, magna cum laude. Brian J. Loughnane, magna cum laude. The Cozen O'Connor Award for Exemplary Moot Court Performance, the Faculty Award for Contributions to the Intellectual Life of the Law School. Jessica M. Starring, magna cum laude. The Kline School of Law Moot Court Award for Excellence in an External Moot Court Competition. Marie Isabella Kazaku. Sarah Ross Fischel, cum laude. The Emily G. Welsh Award for Excellence in Legal Scholarship. Jordan L. Williams, the Carolyn Ager Award for Excellence in Federal Taxation and the Pennsylvania Bar Association Professor Louis Del Luco Memorial Award in Business Law. Brittany R. Namoli, the Public Interest Section of the Philadelphia Bar Association Outstanding Public Interest Student Award. Peter A. Tarari, summa cum laude, the First Trust Bank Award in Transactional Lawyering. Cassidy Paige Heiserman, summa cum laude. Joseph C. Pollenker, cum laude. Matthew Aaron Mantell, cum laude, the First Trust Bank Award in Transactional Lawyering. Pallav Vafsar. Peter Anthony Doulis. Rakisha Yonella Edmonds. Pavel Rosman, the Sarah Narino Perseverance Award. Connor M. Fukune. Aiden Karakoff, cum laude. Mark Gregory Plakta. Rinjan Thomas Barsley. Cody A. Brinner. Craig Gill. Robert G. Fitzgerald. Matthew Rossi. Sean T. Kilkenny. Jacqueline Louise Chakajan, cum laude, the Hector Tillian Terrell and Sager Award in Trusts and Estates. Alexander N. DeMeo. Daniel J. Baer. Zachary M. Bradley, magna cum laude. Benjamin P. Wild. Shauna M. Dugan, cum laude. Francis Raymond McDermott, the Kline Inspector Award for Exceptional Advocacy. Mary E. Lawrence, the American Academy of Matrimonial Lawyers Eric D. Turner Award. Kenneth Grozier. Michael Curry Burke. Frank W. Hosking. Joel P. Nost. Leslie Garcia Pedraza. Juliana Muhaj. Yesh Esfini Chandar. Michael J. Fuentes. Achal Bipin Kanani. Samantha Day Wygand. Ashton L. Taropchak. Alessandra S. Mullen Hoffman, cum laude, the Mindy Friedman Memorial Contract Drafting Award. Casey Lynn Uff. Ethan Dombrowski, cum laude. Joseph M. Schaefer. Margaret Ann Gillespie. Bailey M. Ebby. Alexa Nicole Tsarnas, cum laude. Shane A. Morris. Thomas P. Dinas, magna cum laude, the Carolyn Ager Award for Excellence in Federal Taxation. Timothy J. Wilesall. Christopher F. Cummins. Sean F. Fahey, magna cum laude. Michael McMaster.
Yeah, Michael!
Congratulations.
Megan E. Sprance. Diana T. Damewood. Carla N. Solano. Gabriela S. Sanchez. Logan Catherine Cole, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Achievement in Legal Ethics. Madison T. Harvey. Kristen L. McElroy, cum laude. Gwen Douglas Armstrong. Brittany R. Halpern, the Marshall Brennan Constitutional Literacy Project Outstanding Student Award. Caitlin N. Dryden, cum laude. Ali S. Munchie. James Henry Robert Courteau. Robert J. Vasquez. Sarah Elizabeth Culp, summa cum laude, the Dean's Award for Exceptional Achievement in Law School and the Faculty Award for Contributions to the Intellectual Life of the Law School. Ashley Ray Miller. Raphael Sakala, magna cum laude, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Achievement in Legal Ethics. Alex Goldberg. Spencer Catherine Plant, magna cum laude. Mary Caitlin McDevitt. John W. Norton. Amy K. Lyon, cum laude, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Achievements in Experiential Education. Mariano Nicholas Cepeda. Ryan T. Bradway. Kelsey Jamaro. Kevin O. Bentonker, magna cum laude, the Kline School of Law Trial Team Award for Excellence in Advocacy and the Outstanding Achievement in the Civil Litigation and Dispute Resolution Concentration. Daniel C. Curley, cum laude. Dylan J. Schaefer. Emily Eileen Miles, magna cum laude, the Faculty Award for Outstanding Achievements in Experiential Education. Jared Paul Miller. Thomas Scott Renison, Outstanding Achievement in the Criminal Law Concentration. Catherine Renee Avetta. Sarah Rahman. Jillian Marie Vernick, cum laude. Rachel Elizabeth Shaw. Jessica Marie Molusky, the American Academy of Matrimonial Lawyers Eric D. Turner Award. Robert A. Donovan. Rachel Rempel, cum laude. Jordan Seth Feller. Stephen Todd Barra.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Dave.
Absolutely.
Let's hear it for the class of 2021. You guys did it! You did it! And now I'll be formal. On behalf of the university and the Kline School of Law community, let's once again congratulate our newest law school alumni. All right, you can sit down. Not long. We may be a young school, but we certainly have our traditions. We're going to close, that's right, we're closing now, with a song written by the Nobel laureate Bob Dylan, which captures our hopes for all of our graduates today. And I invite Bridget Fasano to the podium.
Bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true.
was beautiful. Thank you. This concludes our ceremony, a very, very big ceremony for the class of 2021. Please rise and remain standing until the last member of the stage party and the graduating class recesses from the stadium. Thank you so much.